And welcome to Kilmallock for the County Junior A Hurling Championship semi-final between Kiltealy, Drumkeen and St. Kieran's. The Kiltealy team getting their photographs taken. They're dressed in the red and white colours, playing as selected. In goals, John Murphy. Right full back Shane O'Dea, full back Padraig Keogh, and left corner back Kieran Murphy. The half back line, right half back Jerry Murphy, centre half back John Ryan, and left half back David Murphy. Centre field, the captain of the team, Dinny Herdon, and partnering Dinny Herdon in the middle of the field is Darren Connery. Half forward line, Redden Tin, David O'Neill, centre half forward, Paddy Herdon, and left half forward, Kieran McCarthy. Top of the right, James Dalig, full forward, John Connery, and the other corner forward, left corner forward, Conor Herdon. The subs, Tom Kinney, Darren Murphy, Aver O'Dea, Dennis O'Dea, John Herdon, Daniel Houghton, John O'Connell, Owen English, Christopher O'Dea, Mick Dillahunty, Matthew Haney, and the management team of Robert O'Dea, Pat Ryan, John Kiley, first aid, Maureen Murphy, Marie Chavin, Angela Murphy, and the backroom team, Philip Murphy, Robert O'Dea Jr., Steve Murphy, Declan Barry, Eamon O'Dea Jr., and the liaison officer, Robert O'Dea. Yes, Kiltealy hope to be successful. And we're with us in the commentary position today. We have Eamon O'Dea who will do analysis for us. Eamon, a great occasion for Kiltealy Drumkeen.
Wonderful occasion, lads. It's a long time since we're here, and I suppose we're 21 years ago since we were in the county final. So it's a big step up for us. We've been, planning this day for a long time, and hopefully the lads now today will perform for us. And, Kieran's will be a big opposition to us, but we've been planning this young team, and hopefully, the occasion won't get to us. And, we hurl on the day, and that's what we're looking forward to.
Conditions ideal, Eamon. Fine, dry day, pitch in great condition.
Absolutely, it's like a summer's day here, and it'll suit us, I hope, because we're looking for a big pitch, dry conditions. We have a very young lads here, very light, and it'll suit us, hopefully, But, this is Tom Jones shouting in the background there.
Hi, Tom. How are you doing? You're over enthusiastic, looking forward to a great game.
Sure, we're only getting up to the start now. It's great weather, great conditions for it. We have a young team, they're fast, so everything's in their favour at this moment in time. Hopefully, they get off to a good start. These boys will be tough, as indeed all West Limerick boys are, If we can keep in it for the first 10 minutes and get a few scores on the board, it might settle the boys down, who knows after that,
And the conditions are ideal, Tom.
Conditions are perfect out there, you couldn't ask for a finer day this time of the year, This is ideal hurling conditions. It's good for both teams, It'll be interesting to see what way it'll start off for us now, They're up for it, They've been training hard, Some of the boys are off the beer since last Tuesday, so hopefully things will go well for them,
Okay. Right, Tom, we'll have a great game. Rival captains there together. Dinny Herdon, the captain for Kiltealy Drumkeen, and the captain then for St. Kieran's is Sean Windle. Kiltealy Drumkeen have won the toss and play from right to left in the first half.
Okay, so.
And the captain there we thought was Sean Windle, Patrick Windle, wearing number 9, the programme wearing number 8 in reality, there in the middle of the field is referee Mike Meade, everything in readiness for the County Junior A hurling final. Kilteedra keen to have the unique distinction of being in the Junior A football final against Brore A, and here in the county semi-final hoping for the unique Junior A hurling and football contest sport, which would be a unique achievement for the small club. Mike Meade, originally the referee was Aidan Ryan, but Aidan had to cry off the last minute, and Mike Meade is a very, very adequate replacement. Everything in readiness, four midfielders in the centre of the field, and battling for it there and trying to get it up there is Dini Haddon. Dini Haddon taking the action. Ball there between them, the referee possibly throwing the ball. Fine crowd on the far side the field, glorious evening. Noel Broderick there pulling, coming to the centre then, put there Paddy Windle, going to the half-back there, the half-back is David Murphy, starting to get the command here, just probing ball, first attack going, trying to find the full forward is Johnny McCarty, and they've been driven out there to the centre by Sean Windle, this is the centre then, coming to the centre towards Johnny McCarty getting the ball up, they listed full forward, playing centre forward, Johnny McCarty then trying to drive it forward again, set up another attack, good ball down to the corner, down into Don Nolan, great man to take a free point from a long distance, will this prove to be the first point of the good point by Don Nolan. Good start to him for St. Kieran's.
Yeah, Johnny McCarthy's moved out centre forwards and he won a great ball there and great pass by Johnny McCarthy.
So Kilteedra Drumkeen, the custodian there, John Murphy, looking for offside the field. Good ball out by John Murphy, right to the heart of the defence. Where will the breaking ball come down to? The breaking ball goes on further again. Got out there by Paddy McCarthy. Paddy McCarthy dispossessed momentarily. Kilteedra Drumkeen in the attack again. Going to the midfield there. The midfield in question is Dini Haddon, the captain leading by example. Dini Haddon down. Going to the custodian there. And Johnny Grady in his own. Johnny Grady turns defence into attack. Johnny Grady right into the centre then. Batted down there. Going there to the half hour then. And going there to Donald Nolan. Donald Nolan, who's at it very well. A probing ball. But coming out for there is Padraig Keogh. And Keogh strong and tenacious, driving the pass up there to the halfback, by halfback to Jerry Murphy. That's a great ball by Jerry Murphy to Timmy Cattle, the dual sportsman. Plays down the side and tried to set up another score there. Anthony Mullen has a chance of a point. Will he take the opportunity? Drive it high and drive it over the bar. Anthony Mullen now, number 12. Ball comes to Cairns, setting off very well into the centre. Kilteedra Drumkeen, they take there. Good ball brought there by Paddy Haddon. We thought he was fouled, but game for overcarrying. Game 2 minutes old, 2 points for St. Cairns. Kilteedra Drumkeen yet to settle. Paddy McCarty to take it. Deep in concentration. Driving to the far offside of the field, trying to find his brother Johnny. Johnny going after it there, but his flick down there, good water by the fullback. And the fullback in question is Padraig Keogh. Padraig Keogh still in the heavy in the tackle, then trying to block it down, going up to the midfield. Then Noel Broderick, a dangerous point. Ball gone out of the inline, gone wide. Tom Kilteedra Drumkeen, have yet to settle.
Yeah, just to tighten up a little bit there. Good possession there from the St. Kieran's guys, and they're using it well. But to be careful of our clearances, make sure the middle men coming down to the forward.
And a very important point made that the clearances should be done. Very, very good. Keep a puck out this time by John Murphy. John Murphy driving into the centre, trying to find centre forward. They'll get there. Patrick Haddon battling for it then. Trying to get there. Dispossessed momentarily. Seemed to be impeded in his way. Yes, but foulness of for good work there by Paddy Haddon. Chance for Kilteedra Drumkeen to get their opening score of the game. The game about 3 minutes old, 2 points to one. The two scores so far have come from play, the two of them from St. Kieran's. About 67 metres out from the goal now left. The crowd for us side finding difficulty to see with the blinding sun. And the good one by Paddy Haddon is good highest of the good score to boost our confidence.
Yeah, that'll settle him down a little bit now, hopefully, you know. And if they can try and build on that, he'll be doing great.
So 2 points to one, just a solitary point between the teams. Donnie Nolan and Anthony Mullen are the scores for St. Kieran's. Then a point there from free by Paddy Haddon. Ball driven out again to centre. That's a ball, breaking ball, trying to play Johnny McCarty. That battling there with the centre back, improving. John Ryan is again progressing. Coming into the half hour, is Kieran McCarty. McCarty then trying to shake off the tackles of Johnny McCarty. Kieran McCarty and Johnny McCarty do good work there, very near the side, and then trying to be kept in play there. And then was he fouled? Yes, so a free for there. Good work by Darren Connery. Darren, neutral but played great spirit there.
Yeah, Darren has moved out to midfield. He's normally playing half forward. This is his first day midfield for us. And, you know, Darren is very fast and good pair of hands in him. So hopefully we'll see more of this from Darren next hour.
So another chance for Paddy Heddon, but this is not as simple as last one. Difficult shot just inside the 65 metre line. But normally, ever accurate from these situations. Standing, lifting, striking. Looking good from this angle, looking very good. Great play by Paddy Heddon.
Great score.
Well done, Paddy.
Yeah, Paddy has been, you know, clinical when he's on form. He can put him over all day, you know. So.
Tom Jones is hoping that he's in form today and he'll be seeing the green grass of home going home tonight at Poison. So the game, about 5 minutes old, 2 points each, and Paddy hadn't getting the 2 point to freeze for Kiltilly Drunkie in the last one, a majestic effort. As Johnny Graney waiting there, Mike Mead having a word with players in the middle of the field. Just checking that both teams have there. Johnny Graney, off side the field. Backing down there and going for there is Timmy Carroll. Timmy Carroll has swooshed off the ball there. Good work with this in the foul. Paddy hadn't been dispossessed momentarily. Johnny McCarty trying to get up. Stalemate between the referee, pass field, trying the ball. And the ball breaking hither and thither and far offside the field. Backs and forwards battling for it very, very near the side. Kiltilly Drunkeen in the back and coming away then is Conor Heddon. Conor Heddon. Kiltilly Drunkeen setting in the last few minutes.
Yeah, I mean, we've won the last couple of buckouts there. It was crucial for us that we contest the ball there on the half-back line midfield, and the lads now are getting on top of small bits, so hopefully they're getting into the game, you know.
Into the game, says Eamon, and another chance for Dinny Heddon. Dare we say it, another difficult one, but it's a sideline cut. Well cut down the far side, trying to find his corner forward. James Darling, James Vettling for it then. The far side, James still in the action there, trying to coming out there, Sean Winnell. Sean Winnell driving into the centre then, into Timmy Carroll. Timmy Carroll goes up for the centre. Good call, it's foul there. Free and foul on David O'Neill. Right, free. Right in the spot there, Mike Mead, the Ballylanders official. And foul on David O'Neill. There we see it. A gilt-edge opportunity for Paddy Heddon to put this one over the bar. 2 points to his credit so far. Oftentimes on the county semi-final, it can be the easy ones that go astray. This is the easiest of the three so far. He's pointed the last two with clinical precision, standing deep in concentration, standing, lifting his shadow, looking good from this angle, looking very well. Paddy's on song.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest with you, Paddy's our main scoring machine, really, and Paddy has played county minor on 21, so this is no battle to him. And to be honest with you, if Paddy keeps this up for us, like it scores, it frees, we want to keep the scoreboard ticking over, and that's the main thing here over the next.
And definitely the scoreboard ticking over, and Cadence would want to be stop the fouling as Paddy is taking every opportunity and pointing every free. So Kiltilly Drunkeen racing to the lead for the first time in the game. Good puck out for offside the field. Timmy Carroll gets it. Timmy Carroll then rushing to all defenders back towards Paddy McCarty. Paddy McCarty goes left, goes right, then for offside the field. But well plucked there and cut there by Jerry Murphy. Jerry Murphy is hassled from behind. Still Jerry Murphy flicking forward again into the corner forward. Conor Heddon playing a roving role. Conor again. Is he fouled or has gone out? Gone out the far offside. And Conor Heddon just dispossessed momentarily. And the ball going off the stither or off his hurley out for offside the field. It's the line ball for St. Kieran's, the third of the McCarty brothers, Brendan. Brendan left half back, Paddy centre half back, and Johnny Lister at full forward and playing a roving role between centre forward and full forward. Cut by Brendan McCarty, good ball down the far side of the field, trying to find Ian McAsey. Ian McAsey, very skillful player, dispossessed there. Good work by the Kiltilly Drunkeen defence. Cross to John Ryan. John Ryan, difficulty to get it down, danger here, and it's so whipped on there in midair. And trying to get it up there, there's a corner forward there. James Muckle going through. Is that a goal coming up? Oh! A goal coming up. A goal. Ian McAsey. Kiltilly Drumkeen defence could have cleared it.
Yeah, they could have cleared it. You know, it was a mistake. Mistakes do happen. It was a pity because 3 points to two. You know, we were settled. We were getting back into the game again. But look, it's only a goal. It's early days. These boys are great character. They're going to come back into it.
Kiltilly Drumkeen going to come back. And then Kimmy Carroll being marshalled. there, and Jerry Murphy gets for offside the field. Jerry drives down the wing, trying to find the corner foul again. Conor Hedden, and then goes to Paddy McCarthy. Mappy up had the loose ball. Paddy McCarthy out then, out into a dangerous ball coming forward again. Kiltie, the Drumkeen defence tested, but good work there by Shane O'Dea. Shane O'Dea driving it forward again, very, very near the side into the centre field. Noel Braddock Betty down, coming down there to Jerry Murphy. Jerry Murphy turns defence into tech. Good ball down. It's a good move by Kiltie. John Connery there. John Connery trying to shake off the shackles. Believing John Connery, dangerous ball across. Is there a score coming up for Kiltie Drumkeen? But Sean Winnell going through then. Sean Winnell to Paddy McCarthy. Paddy McCarthy goes in then to the outside chance. Paddy heading to one Paddy against the other Paddy, and Paddy McCarthy driving it forward again for offside the game. Chris Hinton, but plucked from midair by Johnny McCarthy. Johnny McCarthy picking it to the centre then. Good ball, but there by Johnny McCarthy. Picked forward again then. And then Kiltie Drumkeen defence improving. David Murphy there, pillar in the left half back. David Murphy very near the side then. Then going back in for then, as I said, Paddy McCarthy mapping up the lowest ball. Into trying to Noel Broderick, but good work there by the centre forward. Paddy Hedden trying to get it up, and then Paddy Hedden get it up, then make his way, gone 10, 20, 30 metres with the ball. Hassle from behind, still Paddy Hedden, but he invite the foul. A heavy check on Paddy Hedden, but he finished with a point, going high and going good. Best point of the game, Sotha.
Yeah, it's an inspirational score there from Paddy. You know, when the chips are down, there's no better man to get the team back into the game. Great score.
Well, an inspirational point, as Tom said, from Paddy Hedden. I think it's Kiltie Drumkeen's first point from the game.
Yeah. We're struggling up front at the moment. We're not holding on to position, but great score there from Paddy.
And Paddy leading by example, driven out by John Grady. John Grady hind to the centre. Johnny McCarthy battling for it there with John Ryan. The two Johns are afield trying the ball. Last 5 minutes were exciting hurling as the game just now gone into its 11th minute. Mike Mead, a quick pull there. Johnny McCarthy pull it down to the side of the field and trying to get up there. Is the halfback in question? The halfback is David Murphy. David Murphy down trying to battle there with James Jolly. James Jolly, but Queen man is 20 to Mike Queen, then drive it far offside the field. But good work there, and good Paddy Keogh getting more confidence as the game is progressing. Good work by Paddy Keogh to the centre again, trying to find this. Is good work then by Kiltie Drumkeen, going down for it then and trying to get it there. It's Paddy Hedden very near the side, and then battling for it to clash the ash. It's line ball for St. Cadens. Driving in there's John Kiley and John McGrath and their players. Mike B. Terry and pull back to Slither. The ball cut there by James Winnell. James Winnell into the centre then, and it's got there. Good work by Jerry Murphy. Jerry Murphy driving forward again, trying to kill Kiltie Drumkeen. Is there a goal coming up now? And there's a great chance for a dangerous looking ball, but John Graney deals with it adequately. Good shot there by John Connery, and John Graney tied to the centre again. Kiltie improving as the game progressing. Batted down there by the midfield, and the midfield in question is Dini Hedden, and battling for the get the ball against Dini Hedden, taking the action and trying to go down and get it also is Brendan McCarthy, and Johnny McCarthy coming out. Brotherly love is evident, killing very near the sideline, trying to find there below Ian Maxey very near the sideline. Good work there by Kieran Murphy appears to be fouled now, so the referee, he loses the advantage. Kieran Murphy into the centre then, and then good work there by Timmy Carroll going through. Timmy Carroll will try to lay off this one, but the Kiltie defence good bat in the other field, throwing the ball again. Tight play, nothing between the teams.
Yeah, it's tough and physical out there now at the moment, and it's a case of, you know, we have to stand up to it, and we're in the game, and that's the main
Johnny thing. McCarthy down again. Johnny McCarthy goes left, goes right, invites the foul and gets the foul. It's Mission Sunday in the ecclesiastical world. The mission here for Kiltie Drumkeen is to get to the county finals, the same for St. Cadens, as Donald Nolan to take it. Nephew of Donnie Nolan, the accordion player. Donald Nolan got the opening point of the game. There's a chance to increase St. Cadens' lead. Normally, Everett dropping high, dropping well, and dropping over the bar. So 13 minutes gone in the opening half. Driven out in by John Murphy right into the middle of the field. Better down there than good work there by the centre-back. The centre-back question is the other. John Ryan runs into a bit of Ayrshire players. John Ryan back to David Murphy. David Murphy trying to get up. And David Murphy shot half back down to the centre then. Be back down between Old Brother there and McQuiggan. And there, oh, heavy tackle there. Darren Conway back into the centre then. And good the half-back. The half-back is Jerry Murphy. Great ball down to the corner, but cut out there by James Windle. James Windle has to be behind there by Conroy Haddon. Good work by Conroy Haddon. Conroy Haddon trying to get the second time. Conroy Haddon get it. Will he try a point from this angle? Make an angle for himself. Or will he prop the ball low into the full foul? Corner foul there. Dave Downey is dispossessed there by Brendan McCarthy. Here's some more line of Kiltiri Drumkeen ball. Sideline cut for Kiltiri Drumkeen. The scoreboard towards right. 1 goal and 3 points for St. Kieran's, 4 points for Kiltiri Drumkeen. Dinny Herdon, the captain, to cut it. Is there a Kiltiri Drumkeen goal coming up just as we approach the first quarter of the game? Sun shining in the players' eyes at the edge of the square. Dinny to cut it. Waiting for it there is Kieran McCarthy. Are we going to see a goal coming up? Not a great one by Dinny this time. Half block down then. Trying to be got again by Paddy McCarthy drive forward then down to Johnny McCarthy has to be behind there by John Ryan. John out to Timmy Cattle drops the sitter and then got grew up by John Ryan then, and Timmy Cattle tries to woo his way, goes to the ground, drives it down past in, trying to find Dolan there, well marshalled by David Murphy. Dolan gone 10-20-30 meters with the ball. Has he a point written all over it? Will he finish with it? That's a great hook by David Murphy. And David Murphy, much to the acclaim of the Kiltiri Drumkeen spectators out into the centre. Where will the breaking ball go? There's very few breaking balls here then, as down there, and it's a free for St. Kieran's. Rather physical game. Switching the St. Kieran's team. Donny Nolan and Timmy Cattle switching places. Paddy McCarthy to take it. Paddy McCarthy for outside the frame, trying to find Johnny Nolan. It's better down there again. Ian Maxey gets it, but the cornerback in question then is Shane O'Dea. Shane O'Dea coming forward, and good work there by Kiltiri Drumkeen. Shot in the grip of the come on. Trying to find a foul there in the centre forward. Yes, didn't get the advantage. And a foul there in Paddy Herdon. Paddy improving. Sixteen minutes gone in the opening half. Is the dry stither come in from the sideline? Had the drop of water. We know is it still or sparkling, but it's still good water. Hardy having to take this one right in the centre of the field. It will be a mighty point if he'll score it, and he'll cut the deficit to solitary point. Standing, lifting, striking. Going looking very well. Majestic point by Paddy.
Yeah, again, Paddy's on target. I mean, to be honest with you, I suppose half scores are going to come from freeze today, and it's important that Paddy scored them. But our full forward line needs to shake up a small bit. A lot of ball going in, and we're making use of it. So
a point between the teams again. And we said at the outset this game could go down to the wire. Paddy going through it again, showing his task on 10, 20, 30 minutes. Are we going to see a goal? We'll be happy to win. Oh! It could have been a goal, Tom, but a great point.
Fantastic point, you know, and Paddy is very sharp with those. When he gets a half an opportunity at all, and he's gone, you know, and I mean, that's going to lift the players great. You know, the half-back line are coming back into it now, and they're beginning to tighten up. You know, there's some great clearances there, you know, about 2 or 3 minutes ago. David Murphy following his man, chasing it, driving it down. Keep on with this, and they'll do well. So.
Kiltiri Drumkeen improving as they're going down again. Ball breaking down again to the other party. Paddy McCarthy get it in. It's heavy challenge then. A good ball driven forward again. Paddy McCarthy trying to set up another score. Look, good work there by the fullback. The fullback in question is Paddy Cure. Paddy Cure trying to head out into a hefty challenge. And then driven across into Norman's land then, and waiting for the vigilant, then driven to the centre. Then chance for Timmy Cattle to get a point. Timmy Cattle drives across over to the centre and then get here there as the car in the forward. Then it's driven forward again. Better down. Good work by the centre back. The centre back in question is John Ryan. And John going to get there is David Murphy. David Murphy, difficulty getting up into heavy challenge. Murphy strikes and Murphy clears. David Murphy driving into the forward again. Little niggly off the ball there. And good work there by the corner forward. The corner forward there is Conor Ahedon. Conor Ahedon across another chance for Kiltiri Drumkeen from that half forward. Dave Tony Hill dropping, but unfortunately over the line and wide. The Kiltiri Drumkeen forward line playing everywhere.
Yeah, Yeah, they're showing better for the ball now, you know, and they're well into the game, you know, and a great loose play over there. Pity he wasn't taken on a bit further, you know, when we put over the bar. But look, at least they're creating the chances, and we're back in the game.
Tom says the chances have been created, and the teams are level, everything to play for. Great atmosphere here in Kilmallock as it's getting there towards Johnny Nolan. Johnny Nolan trying to find the side of the field. The cross over to Anthony Mulnow. Anthony Mulnow drops the ball then. There we go and see Anthony Mulnow point. Anthony Mulnow's shot is blocked down. Then good work there by David Murphy. And great work. And then drive it forward again to the centre. But they go for it. And the ball spins in mid-air. And Mike Breen goes down for it then. And get it up then. And that's in Kiltilly Saint of the upper end at the moment. And the midfielder there in question is Dinny Haddon. Dinny Haddon half blocked down. And Dinny Haddon going for a second. Chased by Johnny Nolan. Dinny Haddon then pull. Dinny Haddon still with the ball. The ball glued to Sullivan. Oh, hefty challenge. It could be the first yellow card. No, so the referee. Looked to be a hefty challenge from our angle.
He was too far away from it.
So Dinny Haddon, his knuckles a little bit warmer as he's taking this one. Driving it right through the centre, trying to find the full forward. Full forward is John Conley. John Conley battling there along with the full back there. Billy Breen, is there a free? Free, said the referee. So nothing between the teams. 6 points to 1-3. The teams are level. Level for the first stage in the game. Sorry, the second stage, they were level after 5 minutes as well. Ball into the centre again. Ball breaking down and trying to get up there. Is the midfield in question? Dinny Haddon. Dinny Haddon, nice sound as the rock of Cashel. Drive it across into Paddy Haddon, a dangerous ball. Is there a score coming up? And great opportunity there. Get that opportunity for James Jarlick. James Jarlick, hits it, but unfortunately, strikes it. Doesn't strike. Slipped a little, and then the stick had ricocheted off his stick and gone out over the inline, gone wide. Kiltilly Drumkeen have the possession, would want to translate into score.
Yeah, we're coming out on top of some of the physical battle down around the middle of the field, and that's going to suit us, but we certainly have to be taking our chances up front. We missed a couple of chances there, and we need to keep that scoreboard taking over. But we'll be happy enough with that scoreline, you know.
Happy enough, says Eamon at the moment, getting to the centre of the field and battling for it there and trying to get it there to Cairns again. And Noel Broderick, probed on towards Anthony Mulnow, and battling for it there and trying to get it up as a James Muckle. And then James Muckle, probing ball across, is half intercept, trying to find Johnny Nolan battling for it there along with David Murphy. Great battle between them. Johnny gets it up the first time. David challenge, and then to Johnny McCarthy. In time, Johnny McCarthy gets it. There's either a foul or a score, and this time there's a foul, invites the foul. The experience, Johnny inviting the foul.
Yeah, you could see that there. Johnny was looking for that foul a long way out, and he ran at his men, but I think there was a handy enough free there at the end. But I must say, like, our backs are playing fairly well there now. Paddy Keogh, John Ryan Cooper there at centre back, beginning to dominate for us, so we've got to keep it going, you know.
So a chance for Donal Nolan. And dare we say it, it looks very easy from this angle. A chance to put St. Kieran's back into the lead. Standing, lifting, striking, going high and going over the bar. St. Kieran's first score after a lapse of 11 minutes. Kiltilly have dominated in the intervening period. Kieran's are back into the game, but there's Shane O'Dea. Shane O'Dea get it up. Shane O'Dea let it there for his comrade foul there. There possibly a booking. David Murphy. Good shot there by Shane O'Dea right into the heart of St. Kieran's defence. Ball coming around there and battling for the centre forward then. Good work there by James Jolly. Exchanges physical. Had to win a free and St. goes skipping this, get you there and going down is Kieran McCarthy out his other half forward. David O'Neill changing direction down to the corner. Good ball by David O'Neill. Good vigilant work there by James Jolly. He slipped past him. He'll make a better effort this now. Oh, clever work by James Jolly. Is that goal we're talking about coming up? They're working well in. This is a great work by Queen back again. St. Kieran's defence. Paddy McCartney, think of the action, hefty challenge there, ball going hither and thither, and they're trying to battle for it in. Stalemate there in the heart of the defence. St. Kieran's trying to get out. Kilty Drunkin get in. John Connery there. John Connery appeared to be fouled. Yes, they're a free, and it's a free. Lots of tenacious tackling there, Tom, around the goal mode. In the cold, you'll be warm there in a short time.
I tell you, full back line for St. Kieran's are very, very strong, you know, but there's great support play, you know, among the Kiltilly boys. You know, you can see that there in the last passage of play there, you know, where everybody was trying to look for the ball and support for the man in possession, you know, and that's how the free came about, and that's key, you know.
So, as Tom said, vital to contest everything, and a great chance then for Paddy Haddon to have the teams level for the third time in the game. They were level at 2 points each, they were level at 1 goal and 3 points and 6 points, and now it looks to be very easy from this side, provided the Slither doesn't slip, because it's a little slippery out in the field. Paddy standing, lifting, striking, and Cindy high, and Cindy over the bar. So Paddy has all the scores got for Kiltilly Drumkeen.
Yeah, I mean, that's the only concern on point. Paddy scored 7 points for so far, and but I mean, once we're keeping the scores going, that's the main thing, like, you know. I mean, the lads, that was a foul on John Connery, and John Battle held for that free. It was his point, really, you know.
John Graney changing direction, trying to find out the middle of the field, trying to find Jimmy Cattle, battling for it there, and get it there as the half. It's gone out over the line, line bar for St. Kieran. It's gone off the stick there of Jerry Murphy. Mike Wendell to take it. Mike Wendell wearing number 23 with a white helmet. Cutting this one very well. It was great back down by the other number 12, Kieran McCarthy. It's going there. Olay tackle there. Could be another booking. Kieran McCarthy tackle there, and Anthony Mulner. Nothing dirty, but just in a bit late. Second yellow card. Free is from where the ball ends. The gilt edge opportunity for Donny Nolan to put St. Kieran's back into the lead. This game approaches 25th minute. Strike it well, and strike it high, and strike it off. So the closing 5 minutes of the opening half, the ball driven out in the midfield, backing it there for the midfield, and trying to get it there is Dinny Haddon. Dinny Haddon in the thick of the action. Then he dispossessed in and by Johnny McCarthy. Johnny McCarthy down, trying to get there is Anthony Mulner. Anthony Mulner into the corner, then down to Ian Maxey, very skillful hurler. Ian Maxey there going left, going right, bringing the back ball back then and trying to find Anthony Mulner. Anthony Mulner down to centre. Noel Broderick has a chance of a point. Will he take the chance? Noel drive it high, but unfortunately gone over the line, gone wide. John McGrath said that Ian should have taken his own point. As John Murphy, mighty puck out by John Murphy, right into the centre. Where will the ball break? Oh, swung around there, and Dinny Haddon caught in mid-air, catching the stither, a mighty fetch, and Dinny swung around, and another chance for Paddy Haddon. He scored all Kiltilly Drumkeen's points so far. Will it be points number 8? Definitely one of the best free takers in junior hurling in the county, has proved in this game so far his 100% record, and it's a very hard thing to maintain in a county semi-final, but fortunately this one dropped over the line and wide. I suppose he's human.
He was entitled to miss one now, in fairness, to be quite honest about it, but I tell you, both sets of teams will have to be careful in giving away frees around the 50-yard line, because both Paddy has scored most of them from frees, you know. The team are working hard to get frees for him, and in most cases he'll put him over, you know. But likewise in our own half back line, they have to be more clinical and not giving away frees, because their number 10 over there seems to be putting a lot of them over the bar.
Mighty fetch there by Jerry Murphy. Jerry Murphy got there by Sean Whittle. Sean Whittle up this side and good work there by the cornerback to Shane O'Dea. Shane O'Dea pulling the ground in into the centre. But get it in is Anthony Mulner. Anthony Mulner over the inline wide, and the M&I sports has missed opportunities in both sides.
Yeah, we got to make better use of that now. I mean, we had a good ball there. Jerry passed a good ball into our forwards, but we were a little bit slow at times picking up the ball. But, you know, in fairness, like, you know, I mean, it's a hard, tough physical battle out here today.
There's no quarter given so far.
So team's evening match, John Murphy, Kiltiri, Drumkeen looking for the leading score before the interval. For offside the field, going up for Dale's Dini Hedden. Dini Hedden, plucky from midair, a very influential figure in the middle of the field, but it's blocked down there by Brendan McCarthy. Dini Hedden trying to win back, but Brendan McCarthy, they're trying to get up there. Break stalemate between him, going down from there, and trying to get it as well as Patrick into the field, possibly throwing the ball. Referee throwing the ball, backs and forwards, back in for outside the field there, pull down then again, and get you there, Johnny McCarthy, down to Ian Maxey, he was told to score the last time, did they see the advice, Ian Maxey on 10, 20, 30 beats, will we see a point from Ian Maxey, and the answer is, yes, good point by Ian Maxey.
Yeah, he got a bit of space there now inside the corner, and good point, well taken, turned well.
So Ian Maxey gets his first point of the game and St. Kieran sixth. Kiltiri Drumkeen, as I said, looking for a score before half time. John Murphy drive it right through the centre, battling for there and trying to get there. Is Dini Hedden into the centre again, coming off his lines there and pulling there by Anthony Mulner. Ian Maxey then growing in stature as the game is progressing. Flicking across into the centre to James Muckle. Are we going to see James Muckle put it over the bar again? High by Muckle and good by Muckle. Oh, dropping the digital square. Good, but John Murphy places his cadence very well to David Murphy. David Murphy, a mighty cadence by David Murphy right through the centre, battling for it there and trying to get it. Is the centre forward in question? There, his party hadn't gone 10-20 minutes, foul from behind, and I suppose there could be another yellow card, personal foul. Paddy McCarthy, very lucky he didn't get a yellow card that time. Lots of personal fouling. Aver O'Dea is on the team. For Cade Murphy.
Robert!
It's kind of an injury, isn't it?
Great chance for Paddy Hedden. And I'm sure he'll score this one. Paddy won the free, made the free, and scored the free. Yeah. And there goes a half-time whistle, and the half-time score, 168 points, just a solid 8 point between the teams. Tom, a very competitive game.
It's a great game, actually, you know. To be honest about it, I'm pleased enough with that result, you know. We're in the game, you know, and there's nothing between us at this moment in time. And the boys have great character. There's no shortage of leaders out there, you know, from our point of view, you know. We have Pádraig Keogh there in the middle, in the full-back position. He was man of the match at the last game. He's leading by example there, you know. He's holding them together, you know. We have John Cooper there holding the centre-forward, and they've tightened up. These boys have been in this position before, you know. I'm sure they can capitalise on it, and I'm almost convinced of it. If they can maybe distribute the ball a bit better down into the full-forward line, you know, well, then there's no reason why those boys inside there won't work hard to get frees, and if they do, well, then Paddy's the very man for putting them over the bar, you know. We're willing it, and we've every chance here.
And I suppose, even in hindsight, the difference at half-time between the teams, I know it's the point, is that goal by St. Kieran's, and if you like, goals win matches, and Kiltiri Drumkeen definitely had the better of the closing quarter.
Yeah, to be honest with you, I mean, the goal was a bit of misfortunate. It was a mistake, two or three mistakes kind of together, and it was a soft enough goal in the end. But to be honest with you, from Kiltiri's point of view, that's a good half. We're happy with that, you know, a point down. We did a good bit of hurling. We still have a lot to come, I think, from them, you know. We've plenty of guys on the bench as well to bring on, so they'll be happy with that. I'm sure the manager will be happy with it. You know, I mean, the point down at half time isn't that bad, and as you say, the goal makes a difference. And but as Tom said before, it's frees here, and a lot of frees are going to be scored here in this match. I think that we got two good free takers on display. St. Kieran's free taker is Donald Nolan, is it? And he's himself and Paddy are having a bit of a shootout there at times, but. It's a physical match, though, you know. We got to be able to stand up to it for long, you know, for the whole next half an hour. And but we have the lads. Kieran came off there. Kieran's carrying an injury. Yeah, Kieran's only 17, you know. So we've got those young lads, I suppose. It's tough on them. But I think the second half, we've plenty to give yet. And they're in the game, and that's the main thing, you know. That's the main thing in this half, you know.
Okay. So, Eamon and Tom, we're in for an exciting second half. So we'll take a break. We'll go for a cup of coffee, and we'll be back after the interval.
Thank you.
Second half, on the half-time score, just a solitary point between the teams. Will it be Kiltiddy Drumkeen? Will it be St. Kieran's in 30 minutes from now? We know the answer to that. As referee there in the centre, throws in the ball. Breaking for it there and trying to get it. Backing for it, there is Sean Wendell. Coming across the edge of the square, is there a goal coming up? Good work there by John Connery. John Connery batting there. Still John Connery in the action. John Connery, great chance for a pointer, but he chats with the goal. John Graney blocks it in the goals. And John Graney turns it out. Kiltiddy Drumkeen setting off very quickly there. And it goes off his helmet there. Off the helmet there of Jerry Murphy. Jerry Murphy batting for the Timmy Carroll. Timmy Carroll then into hefty challenge. Timmy Carroll into the centre then to Johnny McCarthy. Johnny McCarthy uses his body to hush off his opponent. Into the centre then and drive to cut what the. By Paddy Wendell, Paddy Wendell high and Paddy over the bar. Is it? Ball driven up, Dan Murphy and the Kiltiddy Drumkeen team. Ball driven out to the centre there. Battling for it, then whipped across into the centre. Going for there and battling for it with great tenacity. Is Dan Murphy. Dan Murphy in the thick of the action, trying to get it up. Dan Murphy is pushed from behind. Yes, into the midfield. The midfield, Dini Haddon. Dini Haddon into the centre. Good ball by Dini Haddon to the midfield. There, great chance by Dan. Dan, we're going to see a goal here. Dan going to be 30 meters of the ball. Still Dan dispossessed momentarily then. And then over, passively carried into the corner. Back in the corner, back in question. James Winnell. James Winnell. St. Kieran's driving it out. Working it out well then. Into the centre then. Batting creations in defence, trying to get up on the far side of the field. They're batting there. David Murphy. David Murphy gone. Ken Harrison behind. Still David Murphy with the ball. Making angry himself. A delicate shot and a fine shot. And it's. Oh, Johnny Gray dropped it. Is there a goal? Umpires there. And then it's. Oh, whipped out and whipped in. The goalie dropped it. That's the centre then. As Kiltiddy Drumkeen in the initiative. Going here, there's the centre forward. Paddy hadn't gone. Lots of pressure and a great point, Tom.
Yeah, great point. Pity we didn't get the three for the goal. He could have kicked it in, fill it in, or hit over it, or got it in somewhere. But look, we're back in it, and 2 points in a row again. So, or is it 1 point? Is it? One point back in
it. Oh, John Graney there. The ladies had always keep her legs together. As it's by John Graney, doing the hands are offside the field. Backs and forwards batting for it then. As Kiltiddy trying. Seemed to improve the interval, but getting the far side there is then Timon Lough whistle down, foul there, and Johnny McCarthy is a free for St. Kieran's. I suppose as well, Tom, the slither is slippery.
Yeah, but still, you know, it's a fantastic opportunity, you know, and we won't get a whole pile of those in the game. Hopefully we won't live to regret it, but the only good thing about it is at least we got a score out of it rather than going back down the field again, you know.
Just a solitary point between the teams, 168 at half-time, 117. Chance for Donald Nolan high, but unfortunately going over the in-line and wide. They claim that the aim of the scoring goal is the goal to right, whether that's fact or fiction.
Oh, I don't know which way it works, it's going to work in this half, but Kiltiddy have brought on a sub there, Dan Murphy instead of James Darling. And they seem to move him up midfield, and they're playing only a two-man full forward line. I hope this works for us because he's leaving one of their men free in there. But
so chance to open up the St. Kieran's defence. Ball driven off the far offside. Then Donald Nolan get it. Then Donald Nolan to heavy tackling there on the far offside. Kieran McCarthy good work and coming across again. Then Donald Nolan far offside trying to find from the midfielder Sean Winnell. Ball comes between them. Get it. Then trying to get up there is Dini Haddon. Dini Haddon get it. Dini Haddon drive it forward again and drive it down to the centre. There get it. There's the corner. Conor Haddon, a great chance for Conor Haddon. May looking for the man that's free. And the man that's free. There's a half hour. Kieran McCarthy, will he take the point? Kieran McCarthy unfortunately out over the line and wide. So 1-7 to 9 points, looking for a free. Mike Mead. John Graney. Relief that there was no goal conceded the last time. Good puck out by John Green to the side of the field. Up towards Timmy Carroll. Timmy Carroll battling for it then. Timmy Carroll trying to get up there. But get here, there's the midfield. Dan Connery. Too much improved in the second half. Connery gone 10, 20, 30 minutes. Harris by Johnny McCarthy. Dispossessed by Johnny McCarthy. And Johnny McCarthy losing the ball. Then Dan Connery get it again. And then tight hurling the other day. Going away there is Ever O'Dear. And Dan Murphy taking the action as well. And going out then and pulled there. Good pulling there by Jerry Murphy. Jerry Murphy down the side. Trying to corner forward. Then Connery had a sweet shot by Connery Haddon. And a Maggio. we thought it was going over the bar, but Johnny Graney measures his cadence in down to Anthony Mulnow then into the midfielder. To midfielder is James Windle then high again into the corner, then trying to find James Muckle then trying to get the ball up. Great man to get the ball, send the dummy in, the great man to shoot. And this proves it's no exception, it's going high, and so Pearce we going over the bar, good ball, point by James Muckle. So point from James Buckle, Caden's going ahead by two again, for offside then, and going for there and trying to catch his John Ryan, think of the action, but the ball goes out over the sideline. Donny Nolan to take it. Donny Nolan, good cut by Donny Nolan, right to the centre, trying to find Anthony Mulder. Overhead put by Anthony Mulder down that heel. Maxine, dangerous there, is corking up. A good work there by Padraig Kyo, leading by example. Shrugs out, and not Padraig Kyo, but Shane O'Dea, the far offside then. Sits up to halfback David Murphy. Oh, this is good work by Kilkee Drumkeen. Is that goal coming up that we were talking about? Johnny Grady says no, he pulls it out then for offside. But still, the vigilant party hadn't made an end of himself. Will we see another party hadn't pint? Or will he pass it back and said to Cian McCarthy? Great chance for Cian McCarthy. Has he the confidence to take the pint? And the answer is yes, a good pint by Kieran McCarthy.
Yeah, I mean, the two-man full forward line definitely worked there. I mean, he's opening up the St. Kieran's full back line, and maybe that kind of a direct ball into John Connery and Connor Herden will give us more chances like that. So maybe it's going to work a bit, you know, but we've got to be careful how we deliver that ball into the full forward line now.
So about 7 minutes gone in the second half, and all excitement so far. And Johnny Graney pucked out then and fell offside, then going to Paddy McCarthy, get you then. Shuggy off the tackle, dispossessed momentarily. And then Kilkee Drumkeen improving then. Oh, a hefty challenge there. And then going that down to Paddy McCarthy, then gaining possession in a hefty challenge on Paddy McCarthy there, but Paddy hadn't. And then coming down, flicked him there on the ground and trying to get great work there by the centre back, John Ryan, but runs into Johnny McCarthy, holds on to for dear life. Johnny McCarthy down to Timmy Cattle, or to Johnny Nolan. Tries a speculative shot, but the speculative shot is out of the inline wide. Intense tough, Tom, exciting.
Oh, it's very exciting, getting very tight now, you know, and the whole part of space for the players outside it, they're on top of you straight away, you know, and it's anybody's game yet.
Anybody's game, says Tom, and so true, just a pint separating the teams again. A pint at the interval on the scoreline, 168 pints in the pint now on the scoreline, 18 to 10 pints. As the ball driven out by John Murphy, Sean O'Murquig, Boulan and Learoda. Because Tashay fighted his tackle hard wheel and Kilkee Drumkeen in the attack again. But Paddy McCarthy there standing in defence. Murphy up had the loose ball into the far offside of the field and trying to battle for there and get it is David Murphy. David Murphy lit there from midfielder. Dinny hadn't the captain leading by example. Dinny hadn't down to the far offside of the field. Battle there, Ryle, in the corner between James Windle and Conroy hadn't. The ball stalemate between them coming into the centre and get it there. And Kilkee Drumkeen in defence playing very, very well at the moment. And get you there as a half back is forward. The half back in question is David Murphy. David Murphy, have you a great game, the half back line?
Yeah, I mean, to be honest with you, that's David's best man so far this year. He's really coming into play now, really, and some great delivery out of him, you know. David's a fast, wiry young lad, you know. He's been playing minor hurling with Limerick, so he knows this game well. So we need David to be on top of him. And, you know, Dinny Hearn is definitely coming into the game as well for his big time there. So.
And great chance for Paddy Hearn, Tom, to send over the equaliser. I would not say a word of it.
If you want to say a word just in case we jinx him, you know, I'll talk to you afterwards.
Okay, so with those 30 seconds at Paddy places, standing in concentration. Unfortunately, the sun shining into his eyes. Just half a metre outside the 65-metre, driving it into the edge of the square, battling for there and trying to get the Kilkee Drumkeen there, getting down there, and Cairns defence, Paddy McCarthy coming forward again. Paddy hadn't driven it to the centre of the field, and Kilkee defence, brilliant work there by the fullback in question is Padraig Kyo, a colossus, and there, surely a man to rally need here.
Oh, he's a fantastic player, you know. I mean, that's the kind of a move that'll bring everybody on board on the team, you know. I mean, he's a fantastic leader, you know, and the way he plays, you know, is very evident, you know, and in how he drives forward, you know, and brings everybody along with him. He's creating a great feed for Paddy here now again.
Padraig for Paddy, and Paddy, a great chance to level it again and high and over the back.
Great score made by Padraig Kyo.
Great score, as Tom says, made by Padraig Kyo. So the team's level for the first time in the second half and for the fourth time in the game. With the ball going out to the scene, our Kiltiri Drumkeen coming in top. Next score will be a vital score. Battling for there, and for offside is Johnny Nolan. Johnny Nolan then being harassed there by Paddy Haddon. Good work by Paddy Haddon. And then trying to get there is in the back. This is the back of the question. Is John Ryan? Oh, a hefty challenge in John Ryan. And John Ryan is out, put that out, down and then down to Paddy. Paddy will try a spectacular shot. Is that goal we're talking coming about? And Dan battling for there, then bats it down then with the one hand in the hurley. And a great chance for Dan then, straight up the tackle into the edge of the square, but get you there. Plucky is Sean or James Windle. James Windle for offside in, but still Kilkeely Drumkey in the attack. Good ball into the centre then. Didn't knock back quickly, but maybe over here stays. Cadence could regroup again and come into the centre then and get into Johnny McCarthy. And the ball sticks across away from Johnny's path. Going for there is Timmy Cadden and flicked across there out towards the side of the field. And James Muckle there. James Muckle had Anthony Muller. No, Anthony Muller driving into the centre. Johnny McCarthy. Johnny McCarthy then looking for the spare players. There's very few spare players in Kilmarnock. That's good. Driven down then by Anthony Muller. James shot is there, a goal coming up the edge of the square, backs and forwards batting for it. Oh, the custodian goes down, John Murphy, and John gone 10, 20 metres like a greyhound and Shelburne back out to the other Johnny McCarthy. Johnny McCarthy was there, a point for Johnny McCarthy, drives it high and dropping. Oh, the edge of the square, is there a goal? Over the in line and wide.
Two hairy moments there, but we held up firm and we did well.
Just over the in line, we thought there was a goal as the game enters the 11 minute and it's excitement all at fever pitch. 8 points, one goal and 8 points, 11 points, 11 points each. The tricolour not going anywhere. John Murphy the far side of the field trying to find his half back, but it goes towards Johnny Nolan and coming off there, sprinting great but bear by the corner back by Shane Oddy. Shane is fouled and Shane wins the free. John Kiley, deeply involved, the man who played for in Limerick Inter-County footballers, played hurling with, or played football with Galbally, played hurling with Linro, excited here today. The two Johns, in 94, that was 16 years ago, and the other John, John McGrath, and the ball driven out there into the Kiltiris, that goal we're talking about all day coming up now. The ball is driven out to the corner then, and backs and forwards batting for it then, is coming out the edge of the square, and there's been a great chance to get them in chance. Paddy, the two parties batting for their Paddy Heron and Paddy McCarthy, staying made between the two of them. Free trot in, get here. There's a foot forward of John Connery making angry for himself. John Connery, there's a shot. Oh, over the in line and wide. Lots of close misses and near occasions here.
Yeah, 65 there. I mean, John battled brilliantly there again. You know, I mean, it's keeping the opportunities coming, and that's all they're doing up there. And Paddy, hopefully, now will put this over and give us a lead, I think, for the first time in a long time in this game. And that's where we want to be. It's the last quarter where we're going to kick on, so this is where it's going to be. Back in the game. Great play there by Shane Lee in the cornerback position, the last ball. He won a great ball there, 50-50 ball. Challenge, and he went in full hearted and won it.
Inspirational win, an inspirational play by Shane O'Neill, and a chance for Paddy Heron to put his team back in front. The last time they led was the 5th minute of the opening half when they led by 3 points to 2 before St. Cadence got the goal. Hush in the crowd. Paddy drives it, looking very good from this angle, and it's high, and yes, says Paddy. A great point by Paddy.
Yeah, fantastic score by Paddy. Paddy's done most of the score, all the scoring for us there, I say, you know, but if players are working very well around him, you know, and I mean, that score, as Amy just said, there came from the back line with a great clearance from Shane O'Dea, you know, and look, at the end of the day, I've often said it before, the scoreboard only matters once in a game. We're a point up, and let's hopefully to be like that at the end of the game.
So, great work there by Paddy. Hadn't but coming across again. That's Kiltiri going to lead. And there, driven by Anthony Mulno. Anthony Mulno to Paddy McCarthy. St. Kieran's keeping their composure. Down to Ian Maxey, the man who got the goal on the point. Are we going to see another Maxey goal? Invites the free, and it's a free for St. Kieran's. Nolan, great chance to put Kieran's back in level terrace for the 5th time of the game. High and good and over the bar. So the team's led for the 5th time in the game. Who will have the greater result to finish? Ball broken down there and battling for it in and get here there and good what. There forward again and there. Oh, he falls to the ground there. Right, and then Maxey comes in. Then Maxey is fouled again. So chance, Giltage opportunity for Don Lull to put his team ahead again by a point. Standing, lifting, striking, and driving straight between the posts.
You have to watch the free count there, you know. I mean, there's two bad frees in a row there that we're after giving, and every time we give those frees away, particularly in front of goal, we're going to be punished.
Like Tom says, Kiltiri Dunkin will have to be disciplined for the final quarter and not be punished by those frees. John Murphy. Good ball by John Murphy, the side of the field. Going up for then and get it then. It's gone afterhand there of Dinny Hedden. It's a line ball for St. Kieran's. Brendan McCarthy driving very, very near the sideline, going on towards the inline, trying to be kept in play by James Buckle. James Buckle and Harrison behind. James Buckle out into the centre, trying to join in on dispossessed into the midfield into Patrick Quindle. Patrick Quindle across into the centre, but out of the inline and wide. John Murphy looking up the far offside the field. Looking out towards David O'Neill, the ball comes down towards David O'Neill, and David O'Neill going up for it, but the ball goes instead of crossing to the centre, and not David O'Neill, but across this and there by Caden McCarthy, but out of defence then the Cadence, improving Johnny McCarthy, then making an angle for himself. Johnny McCarthy into hefty challenge, Johnny McCarthy drive down into towards Johnny Nolan then, and Johnny Nolan betting for it then, just put up there again, Johnny Nolan get it and make an angle for himself, and we can say Johnny Nolan goal, I would have drive across the edge of the square, shot half back down, good work there, and he's going out over the line and gone wide. Good work by Avery O'Dea.
Yeah.
As it is 65.
No,
wide ball, it's hard to see it. To a quick ball driven out quickly by John Murphy. John Murphy beside the field. Wind off then and get it out. Good work there by the centre forward. The centre forward in question is Paddy Hedden right in the centre then. Great chance now for Drunkeen to come back in level terms. And then ball butting down again, going to Conor forward. And Conor Hedden. Are we going to see Conor Hedden a point? High and good. No! Just marginally wide. ...18 minutes gone the game. Just a point between them. Johnny Graney to puck it out. John Graney driving it right through the centre. Trying to find Anthony Mulnow. Anthony Mulnow betting for offside. But we're what there by David Murphy. David Murphy hasn't done a thing wrong all day. David Murphy trying to set up another attack then. The Kiltiri full forward line there winning the possession. We're hoping to translate into scores. And then across to their main scorer. And their main scorer there is dispossessed there. Paddy isn't dispossessed by Montelli. But coming out there is Patrick Quindle. Now towards Johnny McCarthy. Johnny McCarthy across then into the centre. And driving centre forward again. Down to the corner then. And James Walker coming on across there. But kicked cleverly across there by Shane O'Dea. Good work by Shane O'Dea to the midfielder. Then Dinny Hedden is swung around then. And then doesn't get the advantage into Paddy Windle. Paddy Windle making angle for himself then. But he try a point across into the centre. But Kiltiri Drunkeen cut it out again up into the centre then and get puck in there from mid air and trying to get it up there is Michael Finn the thick of the action and going for it there and good work there by the full forward question is John Conway very near the side then betting for it there and betting for it again quick pass there backs and forward betting for it also betting for the thick of the action is Dan Murphy then Johnny Murphy McCarthy going for Johnny McCarthy driving into the centre again and driving into the midfield in question is Patrick Quinn is there a goal coming up danger all round it and then oh is there a goal over the in line is that a 65 the referee said there was the umpire said it was wide going into the umpires custodian seems to be that is one of the St. Kieran players out. Hard to see from this angle. White ball. Fionnuala escapes round the goal, Motam.
very tight, you know. I could do without those. I prefer if they were more up at the other end of the field now, if I'm to be honest, you know. But at least, look, they're holding tight, you know. And there's some 50-50, Paul. We're going to have to start winning now at this moment in time and try and get up as quick as we possibly can. It's been a long time since it's been above an hour forward line, you know. And when it's been up there, we have to start keeping the scoreboard ticking over. And if we don't, well, then we're going to let St. Kieran's back into the game. Yeah.
So about 10 minutes left in the game. John Murphy looking to inspire his colleagues, high into the centre again, battling for it there and plucked from mid-air then by Paddy Hedden. Paddy Hedden goes into a heavier chance, and Paddy Hedden with one hand in the hurley drives down to the corner and tries up another attack then, and battling for it there in the corner is the half hour. The half hour there is Dave Donnell battling, but Paddy McCarthy comes on then, and Paddy McCarthy then invites a chance, and then Paddy McCarthy right into the centre trying to remain the midfield, but coming out there and batting there, players visibly tired. It goes a nice great chance then for Paddy Hedden. Oh, hooked the last minute then, and again coming down battling for the, there's Dave Donnell trying to get up in the stick. Dave Donnell gets it up in the stick. We see typical Dave Donnell pint going high and going well, and a magical pint.
Great score, you know. Fantastic score. Worked hard for it there out to the wing. It was a tight angle. Great skill putting her over the bar. Well done.
Level aiming for the sixth time in the game.
Oh, we better need that point. We better need it. We're a bit out of it there for the last 5 minutes, but a great score by Davey again. And we're back in it. Down to the rest of the minutes.
So nine minutes left in the game. The cardiac unit in the region. And a lap. And going forward there again is Paddy Hedden. Paddy Hedden continuing to be. Oh, hefty challenge. Oh, was he fouled? No, so they're free then. And there's John Connery. John Connery, the ball blew to stick. So dear life, going forward. And will he invite the foul? Invites the foul. The experience, John.
He invited that well, he played for it well, he got it, and that's what all that matters. Paddy here again is in his range, stands every chance to put it over the bar.
So, Kiltady finishing with a flourish as John Connery is fouled, and Paddy Hedden possibly a pressure point to get the lead. So, 8 minutes left in the game. Paddy pulls up his socks, lets down his socks, looks at the ball, sees the shadow underneath, a pressure shot. Would he respond? And the answer is yes. Great point.
True blue, you know, great man under the freeze, and been shooting great all day, you know, and point ahead now. Hopefully we can build on this, you know, and move on from here.
So 7 minutes left in the game. Great. This contest that was quite in the first half. It was now a rip-roaring, pulsating event high in the far side of the field. Batted down there by Kieran McCarthy then across, got it there, Johnny McCarthy to Paddy McCarthy. It's McCarthy's everywhere. Far offside the field then, batting for it there is Patrick Wendell, and coming out there and trying to get it out there is Dinny Hedden going, or is it the centre-back there is John Ryan tries to work it out again, but it's a difficult thing here, and then driven out across again as batting for dear life. The ball goes to the ground, and then will there a free throw in, or is it a free for St. Kieran? Persistent pressure brought the free.
Yeah, it was a hard call there.
Hard call is right. 7 minutes left in the game. As we said, the last free for Paddy Hedden was a pressure free, and definitely this one, Tom, is it might appear to be easy, but definitely a pressure free as well.
Oh, pressure shot from all these free takers from this distance, you know, and he'll have it all to do, you know. It's a long range out. It's looking to go wide. It's off the post. Ball is still in play. Again, David Murphy, too stalwart, clearing up as always.
I never saw you playing as hard in your life, Tom Jones, as the ball comes out into the centre and get hit in. It's Patrick Wendell off the post and gone out over the sideline. Has the initiative swung in favour of Kiltady Drunkeen?
Well, the pressure is on all sides now, and it's really hot and up here for the last 5 minutes, I think. And to be honest with you, we're in the position we want to be. We're a pint up, and it's a case of they've got to drive on now and keep the pressure on the boys, make them take shots from long distance, and, you know, keep our back line tight. And I think that's the way they're going to work it for the last 10 minutes here.
In biblical times, the wise men came from the east. Are Kiltady going to be successful here? That's good work there by cross by David Murphy. David Murphy placing the ball well, trying to find John Ryan. John Ryan get it up then, inviting the chance. Will he send him? Or is not Shane O'Dea, sorry. Shane O'Dea, but oh, Shane is locked down, but Shane comes the second time. Down to Timmy Carroll. Timmy Carroll's passing to this, and then a chance for Donnie Nolan to make him in for a while ago. Donnie Nolan, there's a square. Oh, good work there by John Murphy. John Murphy trying to find the man that came on as a sub. The man there is Aver O'Dea turns the Vincent attack into the centre there, battling for it there to dear life, and going for down his mic, and battling for it also is Conor Hedden takes the action. It's going down the far outside the field as St. Kieran's come back to try to get the equaliser, driven down there by Patrick Wendell, and then the man that played then Classic again. Is that a goal coming up then? It's taken Classic and Damon Leonard say Kiltini defence housing resolute in the face of adversity, and then there's no one on him but they get that ball up then into Timmy Carroll. Timmy Carroll with his try point and sends the dummy then makes an angle for himself then goes into Barras or Hurley's, but unfortunately over the line and wide.
Great interception there by John Connery, you know. Great interception there by John Connery. Just cut across him at the last minute, just as he was about to strike the ball.
So 5 minutes. We count that as 300 seconds. It's a long time to be in pain. It's a long time to be excited. That's the difference between the county final, a point between a just feet. Mulnow goes in first stage, won the St. Kieran players down injured. Injury time would be at the discretion. The injury time at the discretion of the referee. The scoreboard reads 14 points for Kiltini Drumkeen, 1 goal and 10 for St. Kieran's. A point between the teams. Dare we say it, not insulting the men of Kiltini Drumkeen. Could we have a draw, Tom?
I'd be hoping we put this away with a bit of despair in the last few minutes of the game. You know, there's nothing worse than us spectators watching this, you know what I mean, and these boys pushing us to the pin of our collar and, you know, waiting for the last score of the game. Hopefully we'll be at the right side of it.
So Tom, like Don on the Cheltenham, he hopes the Kiltini win pulling up. So then John Murphy waiting for the get the instructions as Josephine Munro attending there. Is it James Muckle that's down injured? His shoulder injury. It's Pierre James, still in pain. He might be down, but he's certainly not out, or is he looking to be replaced? John McGrath indicating with his hand that there are about 8 minutes left as James Muckle is coming off the St. Kieran's team. John Murphy, the next score will be a vital score. John Murphy standing behind the goal mouth, using the hurley with the big bus, getting plenty of length as the crow is oblivious to what's happening, driving it far offside the field. Ball going down. Where will the breaking ball come down to? Coming far offside the field, going down to get Anthony Mulnow. Anthony Mulnow, there'll be marshalled by David Murphy. Great battle between them. Coming out for it as well is John Connery. And John Connery battling for dear life then. And then Mike being fed across again. And then coming across again. Great work by John Connery. Tenacious. And he walks the foot again high into the centre. Backs and forwards breaking, battling for then. And battling for there in the centre is David O'Neill. David O'Neill taking the action. St. Kieran's trying to get it out. We make it 3 minutes left in the game. Now county injury time. Every minute is precious here at Fitzgerald Park, Kilmallock. And then trying to get him down again for offside then. And trying to get there is Cian McCarthy. But he have the confidence to score a point. Half block the last minute. And again, Chinsa Kiltini Drumkeen going on the attack again. Into the centre, going to midfielder there is Dan Connery. Dan Connery felt it's like playing Connect 4 at the moment. They're trying for far offside. But unfortunately, is it a 65? A vital 65. So it's a just the small things that make the difference. 2 minutes left in the game. It's possibly he has scored many an important point in his distinguished career, but this is possibly the most important 65 he's ever taken. Paddy Heron. They're praying to the infant to pray to St. Jude, and they're hoping that Paddy will put it straight and the cheer will tell the story. This 28 minutes and 22 seconds gone. Paddy hits it well. It's dropping high and it's dropping good and it's dropping over the bar.
Well done, Paddy. Great score. Great score coming for the last 2 minutes of the game here, you know. And fantastic character. Whoever wants it the most now is going to win it. And I think our boys are well offered now at this stage, you know.
2 points is a very awkward lead. And hopefully Kiltini Drumkeen, hopefully Kieran's won't get the goal. Kieran's looking for that elusive goal. John Graney high into the centre, backs and forwards battling for it, coming down into Pat Windle then, and it's battled again by Johnny McCarthy playing his hard work. Johnny McCarthy is never beaten. Will he invite the free? Then Johnny McCarthy falls to the ground and wins the free. George Daly talking about Mary McKillop, the Australian, the first Australian to be canonised. Knowing his great devotion, we'll see if she's a real saint. If she is, he'll find this one. And she's a real saint as high by the. No, is it dropping high out, dropping over the bar? A pint between the teams, time ticking away. John Murphy, excitement. at Fever Pitch. The next score will be vital. Will it be Kiltee Dunkeen? Have we just gone into injury time? And John Murphy drive it high into the centre. Injury time at the discretion of the referee. Ball dropping high, batted on the far offside, then going for there. Johnny McCarty is flicked away from Johnny's wrist. Then Pardy's getting Pardy into the hefty chance. In Pardy still trying to battle his way forward, then turning defence into take down towards Ian Maxey. And then good work there by the corner back. Maxey tries to regain possession, battling between them, staying made for offside. Coming out there is the man who's worked like a torture, John Connery. Connery down to the centre, then battling for it there, far offside, and battling there, trying to get up there. Backs and forwards battled. It's into Timmy Carroll. Timmy Carroll making angry for himself. Timmy Carroll high into the centre, then battling down Anthony Malone. Oh, it's great battle there. It's coming out to Johnny Nolan. Johnny Nolan, he's touching the ground now, so the referee is fit to forward again to Johnny McCarty. If this is the man that'll get an equaliser, I'll invite the foul. Johnny McCarty's the man, but he's hooked by Dave Dunne. Still Johnny McCarty going through, making angry for himself, then across back into the centre, then playing another centre up there for Chris Madigan into the centre, but the custodian comes out, and the custodian in question is John Murphy. That's 42 seconds of injury time gone. It's the great excitement here down to James Windle. James Windle clearing his lines, the back is going forward again, and then drive it forward again. Oh, Paddy Rook, is that going then? And Anthony Mulnoch again, is that goal coming up? We are saying Johnny Nolan, James Maxey, great with the score. Oh! The goal is coming up. Maxey, the hero. James Maxey, the two goal hero, the man for St. Kieran's that got the goal. It just in about 50 seconds of injury time. Can Kiltee come back? John Murphy drive it high up again into the centre there. It's battling down again. Pick and there. Picked out over the sideline line bar for Kiltee Drumkeen. Referee checking his watch. 2:11 to 15 points. Maxey, the hero, getting the fourth goal and getting the second goal. We make it about a minute of injury time. As I said, injury time at the discretion of the referee, Mike Mead, looking at his watch. Dinny hadn't to take it. Dinny hadn't cut it very, very well up towards the end of the side. And then ball breaking down again, trying to get out. St. Kieran's batting for it there is the cornerback, Sean Whittle, to take the action of the field, possibly throwing the ball. Throwing in the ball it is. Ball thrown in there. Battling for Johnny McCarty with it again. Johnny McCarty drive it forward again, and then battling for it then and drive it forward there into the midfield. The midfield in the question, Patrick Windle. There goes the final whistle. Heartbreak for Kiltee Drumkeen.
The goal was a killer blow, you know. I mean, these boys are still learning, you know. I know there's little consolation to them at this moment in time, you know. It just happened at the wrong time, you know. Three minutes ago, the game was ours, you know. The boys played their hearts out, you know. There's great credit due to them. They'll be back again.
Yeah, that hats out.
They did, in all fairness. That's a cruel blow for us, to be honest with you. We were there with 2 minutes to go, and, you know, I mean, those things happen in games like this. You said it 2 minutes ago, 2 points is a very dodgy lead, and we just couldn't pull away, and that goal is hard on us. But listen, these guys have done us proud this year, and we're absolutely more than delighted with that result.
They can hold their heads high. They came out with honours.
Well, look, we come from a small parish, you know. I mean, we have a lot of dual players there who have a lot of mileage, you know, between playing both codes, you know. Every one of those players there, the full squad, you know, and the management, they've all done us proud, you know. They have nothing to be ashamed of, you know. I mean, last year, the footballers got to this stage, you know, and they were beaten, you know. They're now in the county final. These boys, I know, they can do the same. It's only a matter of time, if they can keep them together and keep their heads up after this, that it's only a matter of time before they go to the next stage, you know.
I suppose in the final analysis, overall, look at it from a neutral perspective, hurling with the winner, I know it was cruel and Kiltee Drumkeen in the last minute to lose it, but it was an exceptionally good game of hurling, and both teams gave it everything. Sportsmanship was there, and some outstanding individual players and great skill on both sides.
Look, I mean, it was anybody's game, even in half time. You know, there was nothing in it at half time bar a point, you know, and it fluctuated there a lot in the second half between, you know, us being up and, you know, and Kieran's chasing the game. Kieran's been up and then we chasing the game, you know. Unfortunately, it was always going to come down to a moment like this, you know. I mean, we looked at the ball that stuck in the line there, you know, earlier on. If that was kicked over the line, it could have been a different story. But such are the incidences within which these type of games are won and lost, as it were, you know. But as long as we learn from it, as long as we move on from it, you know, and, you know, I mean, we can only mean for better things in the future, like, you know what I mean? But it was a great game of hurling, you know, in fairness.
Okay, as you say there, both teams will have led in an awful lot, Kiltee Drumkeen, but unfortunately they were looked to be just going to win, just the point and the goal came at the wrong time. But as you said, they did themselves proud in Eamon, they did themselves proud during the year, and hopefully they will have learned an awful lot, and I'm sure that all the underage work has come to fruition, and it is great to get to the semi-final, could be in the final, but just unfortunately the small things make the difference in sport.
Yeah, I mean, you said it there, I mean, small things do make a difference. a lot of this panel are very, very young, you know. I mean, we've experienced guys out there as well, but not as many as we would actually like. These young lads, you know, and I have to say, before I go any further, it's a credit to the underage system that we have in Kiltealy as well, because we wouldn't be in this position only for them. The management that we have out there are just taking them on to the next level, you know. And look, all I can say at this stage, I'm disappointed, you know what I mean? But I'm sure everybody else is, no matter how bad I am, I think it was the offer for the, you know, for the players who poured and gave their hearts and soul out there and gave everything, you know. But look, we'll be back.
And in the word of encouragement to the players and the management team, they try their hats out, just unlucky in the day.
Yeah, there's 25 lads in there that just run around. I said I'm very upset over this result. They came here, want to win this. You know, I know a lot of these guys who were involved with them at minor level. I think we had 7 or 8 minors there togged off today, and they were up for this. They gave it everything, poured their heart into this, they'll be devastated. But look, we had a wonderful year. We had a great management team in place. John Kiley brought us on leaps and bounds from where we were, I suppose, 3 months ago. He instilled a new confidence into these boys. So, I mean, it's all there for us to start again next year. We have to start again and build again, because these lads are young, they're inexperienced, but they will get better. And there's nothing wrong with Limerick hurling either, you know. And, you know, it was a great game of hurling. Good, solid, tough hurling, you know.
As Thomas Eamon said it there, it's a major boost for Kiltealy Drumkey in the future, and the game itself a major boost for Limerick hurling.
Well, it is, yeah, and we've seen it out there with, you know, young David Murphy, you know, as Eamon said earlier on, you know, he had a fantastic game, you know, and he started the year off well by, you know, representing us in the minors. We had Dinny Ahern there, who represented us in the middle of the field there, you know, with the intermediates. We had Paddy Ahern there, who was a minor last year, you know, I mean, who was chasing under 21 titles, you know, and look, these boys are going to bring on all the other lads, you know what I mean? And it's in moments like this, in moments of adversity, is when these boys need to stick together, you know what I mean? And they will stick together, and there's no doubt in that. But one point I'd like to say as well there, you know, is I was talking to a player there last night, you know, and he says, you know, this year, over and above everything, you know, with regards to the personnel that they have on board, you know, and particularly John Kiley, you know, they feel they don't know how to lose, you know, it is unfortunate that'll probably make it all the more difficult for them today, you know. And I know John Kiley, you know what I mean, you know, all the players have tremendous respect for him. I do hope he comes back, you know what I mean, you know, and builds on what he's started here, you know. The player said last night to me, he said, look, he said, we don't care who we play, you know, and that's a fantastic, it's fantastic to hear that coming from a player, you know what I mean, that they're not worried about the opposition, they don't worry about who they are, you know, and no matter what the story is, they feel they can take on anybody, you know. And look, they'll come around, you know what I mean, they'll learn by this experience, you know what I mean, and at the end of the day, they will be better players for it, like, you know.
I'm sure, like Tom and Eamon said, they're learning from the experience, they're better players, and they say thanks to the Kiltealy Drumkey for an outstanding year. Kieran's going to the final, they meet either Effin or Askeaton in the final, and for Kieran, it was a case of staying at it and just getting the goal last minute for Kiltealy Drumkey. Unfortunately, they had 15 scores on the board, 15 points, Kieran said 13, but two of those were goals, and I'm sure that they will have learned a lot from their experience, and for both teams, we wish them both in the future the very, very best of luck. So, a park for Carol to Gil Wackalog, Slán, a Gaeaf Gullier.
That's 3-3.
1-2.
Yeah. Disaster. Oh, my, come on. Give us all comment for the Omai.
Just not in the farm for the
Keep going, go in there.
Come on,
Kiltealy! Where's the ball's in the way. Score on.
3-3 to 2-3. 3-3 to 2-3, that's it. Nice. No, Daniel.
Who are you in again? Who are Kerry then? Kerry the bad piece for his
lens. My Hall O'Connor here beside me.
That's the Ryan we went.
No, I stay there now.
I'm saying it's plenty of him.
That is one of low, Paddy. Look at that.
Paddy, him steps up.
What do you mean?
I know what about her.
Hello, Paddy. Good man, good man. Two points in it, isn't it?
Two points in it, yeah. Fucking.
Yeah.
Man, I know. Edgy, come on, look for the. Pick it in, find a man, oh. Ah, look for the man.
Get the break.
No. You have to barely carry the ball.
They're much bigger.
You have to barely carry it. Mm.
Good boy.
Wait.
Max, get out of the way, Max. Oh.
Oh, that's 2-1, man!
Go on, Darren, get him!
Oh, no, they don't have anything stupid in now. It's alright, it's alright.
Come on, Cairn, pick him up!
That's what the thing is about my match, isn't it?
Cairn, watch your back here! You know, it's stupid now for half-time.
Come on, close in them!
Watch your back here!
Carry it, come on!
Come on,
Alan!
Go on! That's tough. Jeez, he was ahead of himself now. Oh.
Yeah.
Jesus, he's walking out.
Batcher, where is he? Batcher, where is he?
Forward and I'm walking hard enough at home.
Hold him on the jersey.
So he finds up, down at half time.
Now then, looking match up, is that catching match up? Oh, Jesus Christ. Look at this, look at this.
See it?
That's probably just because he won.
Paddy has it in the answer. No! Shit. Oh, Jesus. It is, that's it. We need to get the position out of Darren. Fair play to Darren. Go. Darren has the speed to go over it anyway. So. Now! Lovely. Keep, go on, Dave. Keep going now, lads.
That's the question.
Go on in. Turn in. Go on. Go on. That's it. Go.
Oh.
Get him to go back. He'll be fairly secure. Come on, let's win this one. Again, let's come to the ball. Now. Go away, Darren.
All right.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
They can kick it.
That's it again. Come on. Hit now. Come on.
Oh, lads.
Oh, look at this. You're in trouble again. You see, they're not tracking in. Like, they'll have to.
Come out, team, someone.
Oh, lads.
Score, Thomas, boy.
Let's go.
Come on, Shane!
Oh, look, Dave, get it again, boy.
Ah, geez. Oh.
Keep running.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, my God.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, Jesus, Tom. It's fine, fine.
No.
No, Dave.
I'm done. Bad boy.
No, David! Please go, David! No!
Well done, Jenny!
Come on, Jenny!
Now we have it!
Come on, Pear!
So much offering, call for him!
Pear, come on, Bind! Well done, Pear!
Come on, run on now, Shane!
This!
Now, lads!
Oh, shit! Lads!
Come on! Come on, Shane, up for it! Now, up for it! Now,
Shane!
Go away, Shane!
Look at David! Now, David!
Next!
Get up!
Get
up! Get up!
Good man, David!
David. Look at David, boy!
Watch this again!
Forward, move!
See, go for Nogan there!
Now, David, go! Go up, David! Quickly! Pass to Shane!
No.
He was going to be blocked. He was going to be blocked.
Go on, go on!
No, no, no! Go, go! Oh, Lord! In!
Yes! Go on!
Well done, Jenny!
Very cool.
Yeah, Rachel!
Come on, Alan!
No, more of that, Kinkeely! Well done, Jenny!
Jesus Christ.
Hello, boys.
hands up here.
Dennis,
match up the ball.
Take it back, Hogan, buddy.
To Dennis. Pass.
Yes. Jesus.
Is there any left leg or have
we? Penalty,
should inside the box. Inside the box. No, it's a penalty. What's he giving? Penalty. He's after making up for it, there.
Big compensation penalty.
Let's remember where it is. It is a penalty.
Who's taking it?
The Broggies have to give it. So it has to be a penalty.
We've got it, John, is it?
I'd say so, I don't know. But
who's taking it?
What is it, 3 points, isn't it?
It has to be.
Let's tinker the ball and let it go. He's not on the chain now.
Come on, you're fucking disgraced. So you can't change his fucking mind.
Come on, we're not going to lose this one.
Come on, you big fat bollocks.
Come on, Kilkenny. Come on, we've got to say
it. Come on, Kilkenny.
Fuck's sake. There's
always
an
area. Come
on, no.
On the goal line for fuck's
sake. Watch it here, Paddy. Now, Paddy, it's yours.
Go on, Dave, you're after me.
What happened
here? Come on, lad. He gave a fucking
penny. David, hold the ball. Christ, that way. In again, lad. Put it away, Paddy.
Put it over, Paddy. You've plenty of time.
Now, Paddy, over. Say nothing, lad. No! Oh, shit!
He's up. Look at this. Fucking thing up.
No! Watch it, Paddy. Keep going!
Watch it, Paddy.
Again! Come on, lads. Keep running. Oh, Jesus. Right. Watch my terrain. Oh, that's not an extra man again. Look.
Oh, let's go.
We're looking.
Now, lads.
Come on,
Paddy.
Now, who's here? Come on, Shane! Now, Shane! Get your shit! Come on! Now, David!
Go on, David! Keep going inside!
David, cross!
Come on, Danny!
Call for it, David!
Look at David inside for a great ball!
Now, David! David! Oh. Back to David, look! No!
Give it to me!
You get in camera and he put his hands out.
What did he do? He gave a penalty. No, wait, what's he saying now?
Give a penalty.
What? Yeah, what did he
do?
What? Still can't believe that. But sure, he gave a penalty. You can't change his mind.
Yeah, he trails it.
50 goal.
Now, Paddy, come on, Paddy, yourself.
Come on, Paddy.
And let's help him.
Yes! Oh! Stop going for fucking goal, will you? Jesus Christ, what are they going for goal for? Come on, talk to him. Why are we going for goal? Take your fucking pint now. Go on, tell him to take his pint there before he acts the fucking ear.
Over there, buddy.
Paddy, get your pint.
Be sure.
Come on, lads, come on.
Over the bar. Oh, geez, if he goes for the goal here, I'm going to be shot.
Over there, Paddy.
Good man.
No.
Attack it, lads.
Pick him up, Michael, pick him up.
Go! Why am I not running, lads? Come on, Johnny. Put him down there.
That's well done, Darren. That's fine, Darren.
A ball!
Come on, give him the foot.
Come on, that's Paulie.
Hold him out, Darren.
Let's go. One point in it. For 4 minutes to go. Plus loads of injury time.
Come on again. Shane, drop deeper. Shane Gordon should drop deeper for the kick as he does. Oh, look at this.
Uses some kick. Look at the man gone inside. Come on, keeper, come on.
Why am I keeping him? Fair play. Oh, Mike, you're finding your hole.
All right.
We have trouble again.
All free now.
Now. Lads!
Is it wide?
Wide ball.
Wide ball, yeah.
Come on, let's get it up.
Oh shit, Paddy, come on.
Keep going, lads!
Oh, lads, this is a terror. No!
No, outside, outside!
Come on! Keep running! Come on, Darren! Oh, lovely!
Dennis, keep coming!
Come on, again! Come on, lads! Don't throw it away! Fuck this line, will you?
Fuck it. Well done.
Get your pints.
Go on down, put it over. Yes!
Yes!
Yes, score. Come on, kid Tealing.
Come on, lads.
That's 11 now, is it?
Come on, kid Tealing.
What's in the fight? What's the score?
Win in the kick out.
Come on,
lads. Come on, Shane, pick him up.
It's a level, Tom. Gareth, what's the score? Is it level, lads? Is it pointing to them?
I think it's a point.
Come on, let's go. Lovely!
Jeez, let me never get up to the point.
What the fuck? Big fucker there in the middle. Come on with him, come on.
Keep going, keep
going. Come on, John Davey. Hold him there.
Get up, David, you're all right.
Go back for him, Paddy, will you?
No,
done.
Right. Okay.
Oh, gee.
No,
right. Oh.
No, David, it's coming to you.
Oh, fuck.
No. Give it up to Shane.
Oh, no.
Shane.
What the fuck is that?
Oh, lads, no.
Score. Wide, wide, thank God. Right.
No, lads, come on again, quick.
Oh, your man behind. Well done.
Be sure you're ready. Come on, Paddy. Come on, David. Come on, below. No. No, David, come on.
Kelly, Dennis, look inside. Go on again. All right, ref. Come on, ref, after the ball.
Oh, lads!
Yes!
Come on, David! No, Levin
Pagan!
Come on,
Levin! Don't lose it now! Don't lose it now, for fuck's sake!
Win this!
You gotta win this!
Win the puck out, lads!
Come on!
Foul him.
Come on, David.
Oh, I head down in
it. Come on, David. Come on, David. Come back. Across to Dennis.
Come on, what's he doing?
If they pick
Oh, stop, I'll do
it. It's a pick and draw.
Keep your eye on the play.
Put it away, lad.
We're level now.
We're level, I know. Yeah. If he puts it up, we're right.
He's on the wrong side, though. Have we any left foot on him?
Why do you go deep again for all them lanky goats?
Are you okay? He's
out. What's the time, Owen? What's time, Owen? What's the time like, Owen? Tell him.
Time is up. Time's up.
Oh, yes! Yes!
Shout to him to go away, deep.
Come on, up. Go back, go back. Tell him, go back, go back, go back, go back, go back, go back. Is the time up, Mike?
2 minutes.
Oh, fuck.
You must mark him.
I said we shot the. It sounds like we shot the 20 yards, John. We need this woman in here.
Come on!
Shit. Oh no. Oh, for fuck's sake. Let him kick it, let him kick it. Let him kick it. Ah, no way. Oh, fuck it.
Come on now, lads.
Well done, you lost it. Go on, Darren, take it on. Take it on, Darren, take it on. Oh, ref. On the ground.
If you ran out against him, he had it, sure. Look.
Oh, Jesus.
Go on, Dan.
No!
Give it back to him. Give it back to him. No, have a go. No, have a go. No, have a go. Go on! Who has it?
Again!
Oh, ref!
Ah, for fuck's sake!
I should have worked with better that.
Right! Come on, lads! Go back, lads, will you? Go back!
Keep it going to the end! Keep it going to the end! Go on!
Look at Shane Horton.
No.
Okay. 45 and it will be taken by Pat Hennessy of Galtee Gales. Yeah, he's coming over here at the left hand side. Yes, into a nice stiff breeze now, which I'm taking along, I suppose, for the week, 3.5, 4 minutes to half time. Had in, as you know, standing back. That's taking a big long run at this now, right footed. Drives it fair, well into the end, up they go for it, yes. Brought down there by Jim Hennessy, I think, of Kilkenny Dungeon, who brings it all the way down. Caught by number 12 here, Adrian Ryan, who's in a real solo run. Looked to be fouled, but the referee said play on. Passes across a great ball to Davy O'Neill, who left foot's in around the square. Kilkenny Dungeon, there's a goal. Oh, no, missed it. The goalie, Paul Dyle, clears it out.
Paul Dial clears it out. Coming on now, number 12 battling again for Kilkenny, now gain Edwin Ryan. It's robbed off of him, Galty Gales bringing it out. Francis Stokes battling to get it. Didn't get it. Number 11 we have now. Edward Kennedy, yes, clears it in. Kilkenny don't care, putting on double pressure. Taken inside by number 13, Noel Stokes. Robbed off of him. Galty Gales bringing out his ball. Now they're playing good football at the moment in their stiff breeze. Kilkenny Dungeon still putting double pressure on him. There's a great ball coming out, and Kilkenny Dungeon number 7 was really Joby Hennessy. Yes, Galty Gales doing a lot of shot passing at the moment now with a pile on another attack. Tony Hatton holds up this one. Yes, just misses the ball, but it's gone in again. I think it's all the way, is it? No, yes, the umpire signals the wide ball. That's a kick out for Patrick Lyons and Kilkenny Dungeon. Bitter cold day here in Nagla. I see our lads with caps and coats and collars up as Willie McGrath prepares to take this kick out. Yes, nice one from Willie. Caught by number 9, Sean Dunham for Galty Gales, who floats a high ball in and it's gone to the left of the upright and wide. So with, I think, just moments to go to half time, it's still 2 points for Galty Gales, 1 goal and 5 points for Kilkenny Dungeon. A kick out coming here now, and Galty Gales are in for a shot move. Broken up by Kilkenny Dungeon, but then again, they're back in again. Patrick Lyons makes a good save. Clears his ball out here to the touchline. Terrible bad referee blows, yes, and it's half time. Yes, we're after the dugout with the score. 1-5 for Kilkenny Dungeon, 2 points for Galty Gales.
We're facing a nice breeze, no, in the second half. I don't know. Want their lead, what do you mean, 6 points of lead? They want it all.
Stiff wind. Francis Stokes wins this ball. It's a free for Gantley Gales. Score at the moment is 1-5 to 2 points in favour of Kiltealy Drunkeen. Referee is deciding to throw in the ball between Jim Hennessy and Gantley Gales player. Ball goes up. David O'Neill is fighting for it. Jerry Pindegas. It's going into the far corner. Number five for Kiltealy, Dennis Kennedy. Gantley Gales full back is Kieran Luddy. Kicks a fine ball out to the side of the field. Caught by Kiltealy number 11, Edward Kennedy. And centre back for Gantley Gales. Out over the line. And it's a line ball for Gantley Gales. Number 6, Adrian Ty Carney, that kicks the ball for Gantley Gales. Number 8, big long clearance from Pat Hennessy. Adrian O'Sullivan is under this ball. Well caught by Adrian. He brings the ball up the field. Good drive. Barry Ruffin takes on his man. Good cross by Barry. Gantley Gales full back, who's having a very good game. Ken Luddy sends out a very long ball. And it's free down the field now against Kiltealy Drunkeen. Adrian Sullivan again comes into the rescue. This man is playing an excellent game. Down the field, David O'Neill. David is taking on his man again. This is the best aspect of his play. He likes to take on the backs. Very good ball from David. Again, it's cut out by Gantley Gales, centre back. Francis Stokes with the ball for Kiltealy Drunkeen. Half block down. Gantley Gales number 8. Pat Hennessy with the ball. Flies out to number 6, Ty Carey. Ty Carey is fouled by Francis Stokes. Long ball down. Bit of danger on here now. Number 10 is Martin Casey. Tony Hartnett comes clear now. Great ball. Very proud father of Paddy here in front of us. Great run by Jim Hennessy. Very good play by Jim. Crossing the ball. Great ball across. Full back though comes out again and clears this ball. Kieran Nutty. Joby Hennessy. Great interception. Joby takes on Gantley Gales player. Great ball in. Kiltealy forwards are beginning to fail at this stage. The backmen are really on top for Gantley Gales. Very high ball there for number 12, Martin Luddy. Francis Stokes well under. Plays, sidesteps two men. Here's the ball up. Barry Ruffin catches it. Nice ball out to Adrian O'Sullivan. Adrian half block down. Barry Ruffin challenging Robert Breedy. Adrian Ryan with his ball. He sends it in to Ty Carey under this ball. Ty Carey having a very good second half now for Gantley Gales. Shows the ball to the Kiltealy players and down the field. Long drive. And a free in for Gantley Gales. Tom Spillane was fouled there. Tom Spillane taking this free himself. No, he leaves it to Ty Carey, number 6 for Gantley Gales. Kiltealy under some pressure now at the moment. And the score 1-5 to 2 points. Good ball in. Francis Stokes, yes, Francis is playing very well. Drives out this ball. Adrian Ryan is under. Ty Carey is there. Ty Carey wins it. And a very good pass to number 8. A very good kick. Hits off the upright. Very hard look there by Pat Hennessy of Gantley Gales. Just hit the upright, win wide. Willie McGrath killed Healy, about to kick out this ball. Willie with one of his special long kick outs. Oh, he does badly this time. Tony Hartnett is there. And there's a point for Gantley Gales by Martin Luddy. Gantley Gales inclined to come into this game now at the moment. McGrath kicking out this ball. Comes Adrian Ryan, very good ball. And David O'Neill, and he's plenty of room in front of him. Good ball, David. Into the corner, into Jerry Pendergast. Jerry, yes, well taken up by Jerry Pendergast. And he comes across again. Ty Carey of Galty Gales again comes to the rescue. A long ball down the field by number 5, Frank O'Carroll. Francis Stokes again. Good ball by Francis. Driven in to the 21-yard line. David O'Neill beaten there by the fullback, Kieran Luddy. And it's out over the line. Kiltealy line ball. Francis Stokes about to take this kick. David O'Neill on the ball. And Mike Fox. Kevin Hogan of Galty Gales. Vincent Hogan kicks down the ball to number 10, Martin Casey. It's all over the line from the Galty Gales ball again. Kateri are bringing on a sub at this stage. Paul Hatton, the drunken man, coming onto the field. Brother of Tony, who's playing cornerback, and Noel Stokes makes his exit. Noel is only 12 years of age, very young man on this team. Galty Gales now trying to put on pressure on Kiltealy, and line ball for Galty Gales. Great excitement around me here. The Kiltealy camp are very confident at the moment. They're under severe pressure. Liam Ryan is here, and he onto Paddy Hartnett, slagging him away. Plenty of comments too from Denny McCarthy and Roger McCormick. Oh, dangerous ball in. Well done by Joby Hennessy. Clears the lines anyway. And it's a 45-meter free for Galty Gales. Looking at the crowd across the way there, they've made up mostly of a Kiltealy contingent. I see Dennis Harty over there, and Pat Hennessy, Larry Small. Some of the younger members of the team, Barry Ryan is over there, and Pat Hartnett. Back, 45 now being taken by Galty Gales midfielder. Good ball in. Jim Hennessy is chasing out, and Jim is a very, very strong player. Jim, who won a gold medal in Mosley this year for the shot put under 14 when representing Limerick. An all-rounder, all-round sportsman. A free for Galty Gales. Yes, down to Galty Gales number 8, Pat Hennessy. Very good player, it's Pat Hennessy. Send it to his other midfielder, Kieran O'Donovan. Sorry, Sean O'Donovan. And back to Pat Hennessy again. Pat Hennessy now is putting under pressure on the Kiltealy players. Very, very clear there, Michael John English. Up to David O'Neill. David now sends up the field up to Jim Hennessy. Yes, Jim is beaten for that ball, but to send over the line, it should be a Kiltealy line ball. But the linesman has decided the other way, so it's getting down to Galty Gales. Galty Gales playing from left to right, with the aid of a strong wind at the moment. Up to David O'Neill. David Menton loves to take on his players. Son of famous Kiltealy goalie who won an East Junior Championship in 1969, Martin. Down to Adrian Ryan. Adrian won. One to Clawfield men on the team. Sends in a very good ball. Dennis Kennedy that's on that ball. It goes out to the side. Between Ty Carey. I think it's a 45 for Kiltealy Drunkeen. Going to be taken by Jim Hennessy. Score as it stands at the moment is 1-5 to 2. to 2 pints. Sorry, 1-5 to 3 pints. Celtic Gael is the only scorers in this half. Jim won many brothers to play with Kiltilly Drunkeen. Celtic Gael scares out this ball by Sean O'Donovan. Number 11 is Vincent Hogan, and Vincent fouled by Joby Hennessy. Joby, very tight, hard player. Ball being placed here in front of us now. Mike Fox, Celtic Gael's about to kick it, face up by Barry Reffin. Oh, kicks it very poorly out to the side here. And Celtic Gael's player sends it out over the line. Oh, I think this linesman is after making a big mistake here, because it's definitely a Kiltilly ball. Bad mistake there by the linesman. And Kiltilly anyway, coming out, Willie McGrath, yes, out to the line. David O'Neill is onto this ball. Yes, David, again, as usual, will take on his player. And it's gone out over the line at the far offside, so it's a line ball for Celtic Gael. Number 16, the sub, Celtic Gael, Texas. Line ball. Here comes across the field, Adrian O'Sullivan. Adrian, yes, marshalling that half-back line completely on his own, to himself. Yes, Davy O'Neill. Davy in the thick of things all the time today. Yes, Kiltilly line ball. Adrian Sullivan is the man coming over to take this. Adrian picked up an injury in the first half, which is playing very well again. Now Adrian again. A very long ball down the field. Very referent. Free for Celtic Gael. Robert Breedy was fouled. Sean O'Donovan has been beaten to that ball by Thomas Kennedy. And David O'Neill again takes on the Celtic Gael back then. And yes, he's really gone through and he's well. Oh, just barely wide. David playing very, very well there on the half-forward line. Kiltilly beginning to come into this game now.
That's much time is that? Huh?
Barry Reffin. Celtic Gael's out to this side of the field. Mike Fox would have it. Been pursued by Barry Reffin. 15 minutes gone in this game. Yes, Mike Fox. Jim Hennessy clears the ball out over the line for a Celtic Gael line ball. As Francis Stokes, well caught by Francis Stokes, very good play altogether. Francis with the quick up the left side of the field. Celtic Gael win this ball, yes. Number 8 is Pat Hennessy, very strong player in the middle of the field. And Michael John English, very solid in the cornerback, playing very well. The referee gives a free to Celtic Gael. Two-man tackle there. Johnny O'Neill now is appearing on the scene to support his after coming from Kilmallig. Well, not Kenny after beating Ballybricken. Oh, very dangerous ball, a very dangerous ball. And quickly out off the line by Tony Hartnett, and comes in again and over the bar by Martin Luddy of Celtic Gael. Tony Hartnett saves their home well from being a goal. Another sub coming in from Kiltilly Drunkeen.
Come on, give it up. 20 inside 14.
Are you what's young Hanley's pushing him, lad?
Pat Hennessy goes in instead for Galtee Hales. Jim Hennessy, very strong player, knocks it down to Francis Stokes. Francis out the field. Adrian Ryan clears off the ball and doubled on again by Barry Reffin. Paul Hartnett sends in the ball there. Jerry Pindigas. Yes, and it's 45 made of free. Kiltini beginning to come back into this game now. 17 minutes gone in the game. Jim Hennessy, Kiltini midfield ready to take this 45 meter free. Jim, a very, very strong player. Sure to drive this ball into about the 14 yard line. Yes, as he does, a great ball in. Barry Riffin is just under. Francis Stokes collects it. Francis passes it out. A very good ball, David O'Neill. And a point by David O'Neill. A very good score by Kiltini Drunkleen. Top 10 minutes left in this game. Score 1-6 to 3 points. The umpire had whatever with the referee, I suppose he saw something off the ball, but he seems to be doing nothing about it anyway. His ball comes on middle of the field again. Jim Hennessy again really showing the power and strength made this man. Yes, out over the line by Pat Hennessy of Galtee Hales. Sideline ball now been taken by Jim Hennessy. Jim. Yes, a very good ball. Landon edge of square and free out. Kiltini player in the square. This ball comes out of the side of the field here. And Joby Hennessy punches it down to Barry, Barry Reffin. Barry, after being knocked, the ball is kicked by Jim Hennessy into Willie Hanley. Yes, but a big centre back comes out. Tiger Carey. Free, gets his free. So it's with 12 minutes left and Kiltini going for the first county title under 15 football. Barely missed there by Adrian Sullivan. Ball comes down the field to number 13, Tom Spillane. And that to number 12, Martin Casey. Martin Casey miss. Oh! A free there by the referee, this Brewery man. So. 10 minutes left now. Kiltini camp getting very excited here. Memories in 1989 coming back here. Last time we got a county championship. Very good ball there. Francis Stokes coming clear out with it. Been held up there, but he gets his kick in out to the sideline. Adrian Sullivan is going to be beaten to the line. I'd say yes. Very good effort to get that ball. Galtee Hales now. Number 8, Pat Hennessy kicks in this ball. Morgan Sullivan here, and he giving out to his brother inside. And yes, Kiltini, we want to keep him out here now. Wouldn't want to let it happen. Oh, it's gone in. It's gone in. It's gone in by number 8. Pat Hennessy. 1-4 to 1-6. There's only 2 points in this game now. That's bringing him back very close now. One four, one six. and out to Jim Hennessy. Well, well caught by Jim Hennessy. A great clearance up the field. It's a crucial time now for Kiltili, Dunkina and Galty Gales. And this breeze is getting stiffer all the time. There's again the free Packy Rifford down the background. One of the mentors of this team, vice chairman of the club. And Johnny Pendergast playing very well. Good ball across the square, yes. And the goalie clears it. Ball comes out middle of the field. Jim Hennessy, Kiltili, Duncan gets it. Sidesteps one man. And going through, yes. Very strong. Johnny Pendergast barely missed that ball. The goalkeeper out to Adrian Ryan. Adrian out. Pass it out to Adrian O'Sullivan. Adrian half blocked down there by number 7, Mike Fox of Guilty Gales. Joby Hennessy. Joby drives in the ball into the 40-yard line. Swung in there by Adrian Ryan there. Number 6, Ty Carey. Give it ball. Francis Stokes with it now. Francis. And very well clear, sends it up the field. David O'Neill and Vincent Hogan battle on for this one. David seems to get the better of it so far. Yes, and David takes him on again. A very good ball across the 14-yard line. None forwards there goes the number 7, Matty Fox. Barry Ruffin gets this ball. And it's free in from foul after kicking the ball. So, free from Barry.
One six to one four.
1-6-1-4, 8 minutes left. Reliably informed there by Dennis McCarthy, my timekeeper and scorekeeper. Francis Stokes, we kick this with the Kitog. On 14 yards out. Yes, and over the bar, very good score, pressure score there. Very cool man altogether, Francis Stokes. Daily crowd around now is cheering, getting excited. Mike Stokes is up and down the line, the far offside. Blood is beginning to boil. Jim Hennessy playing very well in the middle of the field. Really loud in this game there now. Sends it in, Timmy Hanley. It comes out Adrian Ryan. Back into Barry Riffin. Very good ball. Barry, very lucky there. Jim Hennessy and over the bar. Oh, Jim Hennessy's lording it down the middle of the field now for Kiltili. That's 1-8 now to 1-4. So Kiltili lads are walking up again and beginning to play very good football. Out to this side of the field. Francis Stokes now. Next on. No one mess up between himself and David Hennessy, but Joby Hennessy comes into the rescue. David sends it down, but Ty Carey gets the ball. Back down to Joby. And Joby likes to be going forward and very strong player too. He is very good. Half block down there, but it's still coming in there to Paul Reffin, Paul Hartnett. Cleared there by Nicholas Bailey of Galty Gales. And Michael John English, very good there, cornerback. Michael John is playing a very good game today. Adrian O'Sullivan about to kick this ball. 6 minutes left in the game. Good ball across the middle of the field. Jim Hennessy there under this ball. Cleared there by Pat Hennessy of Galty Gales. And Adrian O'Sullivan is under as well again this time and playing very well centre back. Ball comes in, Tony Hartnett. Tony, tall player. And O'Sullivan coming out to the side of the field. Carries it up along the line here. number 9 Sean O'Donovan sends in the ball for Galtee Gales into penalty. A high ball in, and it's gone wide, it's gone wide. And just 7 minutes to go now. 7 minutes, Kiltilly don't get away from a county final. They win 1-8 to 1-4. While being kicked out by William McGrath. David O'Neill gone back down into the backs. There's this ball. And it's all over. This is a great win for the Kiltilly Drunkeen lads. All the mentors coming in there. Paddy Sullivan, Philip Hussle, Packy Reffin. So they play very well today, Kiltilly Drunkeen. And great things are in the future for this team.
No, I'm fine. Who's trying to take the photographs there?
Bye. You
got to put your hand in, you know, this winner. Lads, when did you think the tournament point was coming?
Thank you. I've been down to 5,000. I've been down to 5,000.
One more stop. Just press it down.
My tie's straight there, Mike.
The tie is all right, but the head is a bit sideways.
Well done. I got that.